Welcome, class, to our topic, Rizal the Novelist. And we're going to take a look, bakit ang mga nobela ni Rizal very controversial? And eventually, bakit naging dahilan ito na kaya siya, he was exiled in Dapitan, and his name was implicated with the Katipunan. Kaya siya pinatay, kasi siya daw ang mastermind ng Katipunan because of his writings. Now, let's clarify first, what is a novel? Okay, so I have here several novels who are well-known, okay, mga best-selling. I have here The 100 Years of Solitude by Gabriel Garcia Marquez. Okay, personally, of course, ito yung mga nabasa ko, paborito ko. Another thing from Gabriel Marquez, Love in the Time of Cholera. It's a great story of quarantine. Okay, talagang naka-quarantine ang mga tao dati because when cholera struck, okay, hindi sila pwede magpababa ng mga tao kasi baka makahawa. And then, the last novel that I would like to just present this afternoon is actually Things Fall Apart by Chinua Achebe. Okay? I got this from World Lit class way back in college, and it contains, it's a tragic story, but nevertheless a very good story about the survival of a culture. Okay? So, what is your favorite novel? Nagbabasa ka ba? Anong nobela ang nabasa mo na talagang it became your favorite? Now, the reason why I introduced this novel to you because these are well-known, but okay, hindi naman siguro pinersecute ang author because of what they have written. Unlike Rizal, when he published his novel, particularly Nolimi Tangere, he was a marked man. He became a marked man. And talagang bilang na ang buhay ni Rizal, ang araw ni Rizal, nung time na yon. Now, let's differentiate what is a novel and what is a book. So on the left side is the book. It's usually handwritten, printed work, fiction or non-fiction. Meanwhile, to the right side is the novel. It's a long prose, okay, that describes fictional characters. And again, on the second part, it's either fiction or non-fiction. Meanwhile, novels are fiction, okay? So kaya nga yung novela ni Dan Brown, Da Vinci Code, grabe controversial yon, talagang bina ng church. The point is, it's a fiction, meaning say it's a pigment of the author's imagination, despite the fact that he weaved the story from historical realities. And then book is a general term, okay? It's gonna be a book of magic, a book of sacred prayers. Meanwhile, novel is a form of a book. It's just under the book. Okay, so maliit lang na, mas maliit ang novel kaysa book. Meanwhile, books, okay, books, books of the Bible, something like that. And then lastly, book is written, printed, illustrated, work or blank sheet. Meanwhile, novel is written or printed on a book. So novel is always a part of the book. That is why Nolimi Tangere and Elfidi, they are novels because they are, at the same time, they're books. Ginawang subject yan nung high school alongside with Florante at Laura and Ibong Adarna. Now let's go straight to the heart of the topic, the two novels of Rizal. Let's have number one, the novel Nolimi Tangere. It means Do Not Touch Me or Touch Me Not. It was published in Berlin, Germany, 1887. It consists of 64 chapters, and Rizal took like 3 years to write this novel. And this novel is actually described as a romantic novel, di ba? Romance. And the savior of this novel is Maximo Viola. Why savior? Kasi according to the account, during that time, Rizal is like wala nang pera, he's so broke. And according to the account, he's imagining throwing the manuscript into the fireplace. It's a very fortunate thing that Maximo Viola came and lended his money. And it's the work of the heart. You would see the author's heart in loving the country, in portraying the ordinary scenes during the time. And that's really a work of the heart. Okay? So another thing that is distinct about Rizal's novel is the dedication. Usually whenever we read books, we go to the dedication portion, we usually see yung mga mahal sa buhay ng author, yung mga taong tumulong. But ibahin nyo si Rizal. He dedicated this book to the fatherland or bayan. Okay? And in the dedication, pinakita niya ano ang kanyang purpose at anong ginamit niyang jargon. Sabi rito, recorded in the history of human sufferings is a cancer. So malignant, a character that least touch irritates it and awaken it in the sharpest pains. So ginamit ni Rizal, dahil doctor siya, he used the jargon of medicine in order to describe the social injustices and the evils of the society during the time. He compared it to cancer. At alam natin ang cancer ay talagang isang terminal illness, isang mabigat na sakit na it caused so much pain. At the same time, talagang matutuluyan ka talaga. So Rizal is, understandably, he's a doctor, and the way he used the medical jargon is so fitted for a man of his stature. So in here, pinakita niya na may sakit ang bayan, Okay, and that's why, sabi niya, to this end, I will strive to reproduce thy condition faithfully, without discriminations. I will raise a part of the veil that covers thee. Sabi niya, ipapakita ko ang mga kabulukan, ang cancer na nangyayari. So, di ba? Ang ganda ng dedication na Rizal. So, no limit tangere. Let's have a short analysis. Number one, it is a book of feelings. Okay? It has love, revenge, lust, etc. Makita natin ang story about Maria Clara ni Ibarra. Makita natin yung gustong maghiganti ni Ibarra because his father died at the hands of the friar, Padre Damaso. Nakita natin yung lust, di ba? Yung si Padre Salviata, if I'm not mistaken, may mali siya towards Maria Clara, di ba? And that's also a book of colors. Dito pinakita ni Rizal ang kanyang pagiging well-rounded individual. Ang novel na to, Completos Ricados, okay? It's a well-rounded novel. May katatawanan, may compassion, may mga makulay na mga scenes, di ba? It's very fresh. Very, parang galing sa Europe yung si Ibarra, and then parang he see things differently, lalo na galing siya sa Europe. And then, it's a book of romance. Sabi nga, if you would remove Padre Damaso from the story, you would be left with nothing else but a love story. Usaping pag-ibig, Ibarra and Maria Clara, hindi nagkatuloyan. And then, it is a book of disease. Again, Rizal used the word cancer. He actually revealed the evils and injustices, okay, that is happening during the time. And then it's a book of change. Okay, we have two characters. Ibarra wanted to change things using school education, di ba? Parang si Rizal lang. And then we have Edias, okay, wanted to revolt, medyo mas violente. So nakita natin ang transition. So Edias sacrifices life for Ibarra, and Ibarra survived only to be bitter and to get revenge. That's why nagkaroon ng El Filibusterismo. So those are the short analysis of Noli Metangere as a book. Again, it's a book of feelings, book of colors, book of romance, book of disease. Na parang doktor na doktor, may sakit ang lipunan, and book of change. Okay? Meanwhile, the El Filibusterismo, let's have the basic information. It was published in Ghent. We called it the Reign of Greed, 1891. Sinimulan ni Rizal na isulat ito when he was a practicing doctor in Calamba, nung buong isya ng Pilipinas. And then, it consists of 38 chapters. If you would notice, maikli ang El Fili kaysa Noli. Siyempre, di ba? Kulang sa pondo. At the same time, Rizal back then, medyo iba na kanyang pag-iisip. It's a political novel. Ito talaga, kita-kita yung advocacy ni Rizal for a change. And just like with the Noli, he went out of money. Okay? Wala na siyang pera nung time na yan. And a savior came in the name of Valentin Ventura. And while Noli is a work of the heart, other scholars are saying that El Fili is a work of the head. Mas wais na si Rizal. Mas hindi na puso, utak na. Okay, another thing, just like with Noli, with the dedication, nakakatuwa si Rizal. He dedicated the three martyrs of Bagumbayan. Remember, class, that when Rizal died, or when Rizal entered Ateneo, he was 11 years old when the three martyrs were executed in Bagumbayan. 11 years old si Rizal. Hindi siya nakalimot. Hindi siya nakalimot. And sa kanyang novel, dinedicate niya ang libro na yun para sa tatlong pari na namatay. Wow, 11 years old. And when he wrote this, actually it's like 27 or 29 years old. Diba? Parang wow. Ganun ka laking impact ng tatlong pari na ito kay Rizal. And then, for the El Fili, it's a book of bitterness. Okay? Hatred. Galit na galit siya dito. Si Simon na mag-aalahas. Da? Na si Ibarra rin yon. Nag-return siya. Da? He did return to exact revenge, okay, upon his enemies. And it's a book of rebellion. He is instigating the young people to rebel. And he has this conspiracy to blow up, okay, the government and the church people during the time. It's a book of sorrow. Nakakalungkot to. Okay? Namatayan. Tapos si Maria Clara namatay sa sakit, eventually. And it's a book of violence. So makita mo natin, mas dark, di ba? Parang ganito, mas dark ang El Fili kumpara sa Noli. Ang Noli kasi parang sarap panoorin eh. Parang wow, love story, may mga picnic, di ba? May mga piyesta. Eto si El Fili, hindi eh. Talaga disguise. And the Avenger na si ano dito, si Ibarra. Nag-disguise pa siya at nakuha niya yung kayamanan ng mula kay Elias. And he masked himself as Simong Mag-aalhas or the jeweler, di ba? Nagbebeta ng alhas. And he associated himself with the powerful. Pinakita ni Rizal, In order for you to change the system, dalawang bagay. Una, you get out and you form another system. Pangalawa, you penetrate the system and change it from within. So in El Fili, society is urged to open its eyes to the reality and rebel against the Spanish government. So yan ang pinagkaiba nila. Okay? Talagang mas galit si Rizal sa El Fili, mas dark. Pero ang nangyari sa end, di ba? Despite of the rebellion, si Basilio eh, sinave niya pa rin. Si Isagani pala, sorry. Sinave niya pa rin yung kanyang girlfriend. So, nathwart ang revolution. And eventually, Ibarra died. He revealed himself to Padre Florentino. Nag-confess siya sa priest. At ang priest, because of this very, very tragic life of Ibarra, na sabi niya, yung kayamanan ni Ibarra, tinapon niya sa dagat. And then, as he threw the treasures into the middle of the sea, he says, he issued the challenge. Sabi niya, where are the youth who will consecrate their golden hours, their illusions, and their enthusiasm to the welfare of their native land? Where are the youth who will generously pour out their blood to wash away so much shame, so much crime, so much abomination? Pure and spotless must the victim be, that the sacrifice may be acceptable. Where are you, youth, who will embody in yourselves the vigor of life that has left our veins, the purity of ideas that has been contaminated in our brains, the fire of enthusiasm that has been quenched in our hearts? We await you, O youth. Come, for we await you. So that is the challenge of Rizal. The pinarating niya na, okay, nagkaleche-leche man tong nobela na ito. At the end of the day, I would still put my hope sa mga susunod na generation that they would love this country and they would give their lives also for the welfare of this country. So ang tanong, what happened after these novels were published, the legacy of Rizal? Siyempre, ang nangyari, pinag-initan siya. Number one, he exposed the evils, okay? The impact of Rizal's novels. It exposed the evils and injustices of the Spanish colonial government and the friars. Nabuking. Not that they don't know that is happening, but the point is somebody, okay? Somebody, parang yung story na the emperor's new clothes, di ba? Yung bata, siya yung nagsabi na walang damit ang emperor. While others are saying, hindi, may damit, maganda. So si Rizal hindi siya nagbulag-bulagan. Number two, because of these novels, he became a marked man. Lalo na ng mga friars. Eto nga, galit na galit si Padre Damaso. Tinawag siyang erehe, yung mga pare. Heretic. Binan yung novel. Kaya tumaas ang price eh, binan. Alam niyo naman, pagbawal, lalong nakiyur sa mga tao. And then, talagang hanggang sa Spanish Senate Hall, talagang naging controversial yung mga nobela ni Rizal. And the last one, of course, it exposed the Filipinos to the call to evaluate their suffering. Sinasabi ni Rizal na, alam niyo nagsasuffer tayo, pero anong gagawin natin? Diba? Kung maririnig lang natin yung sabi ng mga tao after the novel were banned or novels were banned, siguro sasabihin ng mga tao, kita mo kaya ayaw nila ipabasa yan eh. Kitang-kita yung kalokohan nila. Sabi nila, totoo naman yung mga nasa nobela. Lagi tayong kawawa, saka abusado yung mga priling yan. Sabi sa pahirap pagkatapos na, balita ko may pasabog si Rizal sa nobelang yan. Or kitang-kita yung mga nangyayari ngayon, nakabulastugan. Kaya pala galit na galit ang mga prile. You have to understand that after the novel was published, talagang all praises ang friends ni Rizal. But he also gained a lot of enemies. Same with El Fili. Pinuri ng mga kaibigan, mas dumami ang kaaway ni Rizal. And because of that, it would send Rizal to his demise. Okay? Dahil doon, pinatapon siya at bilang na ang kanyang araw. But still, he wrote this novel not just to gain money, not just to have an intellectual superiority, show of intellectuality, but to actually call and inspire people na, hey, hindi tayo dapat manatiling ganyan. Okay? So, what do you think are the other impacts, okay, of Rizal's novels in development of Philippine nationalism? Paano pa kaya nakatulong ito para ma-develop yung pagmamahal sa bayan ng mga tao noong time na yun? Remember, Bonifacio, established KKK, he was inspired by the writings of Rizal, lalo na sa mga idea ng revolution ng Rizal. Okay? So thank you. May quiz tayo at may sit work dito. Thank you.